Carl knew that on one of these shores stood William Hamilton's lavish mansion. And there, the detective had hopes of finding a way out of the area. A phone, a truck, and who knows, under the luxurious paneling and damask carpets, he might be able to find answers to his questions. The detective wondered about the floating debris. Had it drifted out from the shore, or had it been abandoned there in the middle of nowhere? Carl saw a boat in the distance, clearly piloted by one of his own. Had he finally made it to civilization? His hopes were immediately drowned out by the sounds of gunshots. Time to flee again, and fast. Yet each stroke was desperate. The icy water and his wounds made him feel weaker and weaker. He had to get to shore. Bleeding and the hypothermia were tearing at Carl's poor body. When he finally saw a light in the distance, he was filled with a faint sense of hope. Could it be a refuge? Carl was convinced that he would not wake up if he went to sleep in this state. It was probably best to make a fire and take a look at his wounds. The red glow of the flames allowed Carl to see the full extent of his injuries. Carl struggled to wake up. His makeshift bandages offered him little time. If he wanted to find the truth, he had to get to Hamilton Manor without delay. Carl left his makeshift refuge. He knew where he was going. A more comfortable but otherwise unsettling place, Hamilton's mansion. Carl tried to put the horror into perspective. Accidents happen, and in the inhospitable far north, it happens more often than not. Nevertheless, a feeling of déjà vu stayed with him, as if the carnage was not over. The plan suggested that a package had to be retrieved not far away. Carl had to keep his eyes open. A magnetic card, the HMC was definitely equipped with the latest technology. What could it open? What were these mysterious fragments, and why was there a warning about the mist? This letter raised more questions than it answered for the detective. The detector indicated radioactive material nearby. The radiation detector did not indicate any danger. He knew that wolves do not attack people, but still, he had to be careful.